Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D, and today's 3D modeling tool is Edge Slide. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how it works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. I am using Cinema 4D 2024 in this tutorial. At the time I am recording, it is the most up-to-date version. And if I go into Window, Asset Browser, you'll see that we have some models here in this folder here. And the reason why I'm bringing up this exact update version right now is because you might have different models in your asset browser depending on what version you're working in. So you might have different ones that you could use for this example to try out this tool. And really any model works. It's just good to choose one that has some nice curvature on it. So I thought it would be good for this one, if you're working in the same version and you have the same models as me, to use one of the sculpting base meshes. So let's click on this female bust for right now, and it'll download it and add it into our scene. And I'll zoom in here. I'm going to turn on our display, garage shading lines, and we're going to show how this tool works specifically using this model. I'll go into edge mode, and since we're using this new tool today, the hotkey for it is MO. And you can see when you press the M button, there's this drop down menu that comes up, and you'll see under O is slide. So that's our edge slide tool. So if I click MO, then we have our edge slide, and you can see it come up in our attributes manager over here, all the different settings for it. And you can see we have offset shift, offset mode, and we'll go through what all of these mean. But first, before we use edge slide, we need to select what edges we're going to be moving. So this is really great for moving loops and having a lot of control. And you can even keep your curvature or clone loops. There's so many options. So just to start off with, we're going to use another hotkey that we have covered previously for selecting loops, and that is UL. So I'll click U and L. And let's just start off by clicking this loop right here because it's a good example. And we'll use MO for edge slide. So now we have our loop selected and we have edge slide. So there's a couple ways to adjust the offset. You can adjust it by adjusting the slider here. You can also just click and drag your mouse, and you can see we're sliding this loop. And you could even slide other loops like around the eyes. So I could use UL and even slide a loop as complicated as this using this tool. And you can see that as I'm moving this, you can see our offset is adjusting in our attribute manager. And right now our offset is showing in centimeters. So it doesn't have to be showing an exact distance in whatever units you have your project set up in. So I'll hit undo. You could also have proportional turned on. So fixed distance, you offset using a fixed distance. So you're going to have centimeters or inches or whatever units you're working in to adjust how much you're sliding the surface. But you could also use proportional if you prefer to use a percentage. So here you can see I'm sliding with a percentage, and it looks much more proportional to the loops around it. It changes how it looks when you use a percentage instead of an exact distance. So that's just something to keep in mind while you're using this tool, because depending on what you're modeling, you might want to go for a different option. So that's what offset does, and fixed distance and proportional affect your offset. I'm going to go ahead and click on this loop down here again, and I'll use MO to open up our edge slide once again. So shift is another option. You know, if we just click and drag as usual, we're just moving this back and forth. If we hold down shift, hence the name, easy to remember because it's called shift. And what shift does is it moves that loop in the normal direction relative to the location of the loop. So if I move my mouse in, we are moving this in the normal direction inwards. If I move my mouse to the right, it's going to go outwards. I'll hit undo. And you'll notice we have other options here. So limit, I'll show you what limit does, but first we need to show what happens when you have limit off. I can slide this loop back and forth. It's not being limited by anything. I can go as far as I want or anything basically, but it looks a little weird. So sometimes you want to limit that to just stay within these edges and points here so that nothing looks weird. So if you want to do that, you click this button here and it restricts it. I can't go further than the other points there. I can't go further than the other points there. So it restricts it between those two sets of loops. And that can be pretty helpful. I actually want to show how preserve curvature works on a different example so they can see it more clearly. So for right now, I'm going to skip over into clone. So clone, you can temporarily turn this on by holding down control, clicking and dragging your mouse, and it'll clone that initial loop that we had. So I'll hit undo so you can see that again. We have this loop selected. I hold down control and click and drag. We have cloned that first loop. So that is what that does. And that can be pretty useful. But now I want to go over preserve curvature. So for preserve curvature, I'm actually going to use a torus as an example. So I'm just going to hide that female bust. And we're going to hold a click on this cube so that we can see our different primitive options. And down here we have a torus. I'll click on our torus, and our torus is pretty large, so I'm just going to zoom out a bit. And I'm going to reduce the segments down to, let's say, 5 feels like a good number to me. And I want to make this editable so that we can adjust the edges as we were doing on that female bust. That was editable. And when we make this editable, the torus, it'll change from this torus icon to a triangle icon similar to what we see for this female bust. And you can do that by clicking this button here or hitting C, and that will make this into a polygonal object. So I'll hit C, and now you can see that the icon next to our torus has changed. So it's the same kind of object now as our female bust. And I'll use UL to select a loop here. And we're going to use MO, as you can guess, because we're going to slide this edge. But this time we're going to slide it using clone. And if you click this here, it'll keep the clone option on and you don't need to hold down control anymore to use it. And now that we've done that, we're also going to show how preserve curvature works. So I'm going to turn on preserve curvature and show you how that looks a little bit. So you can see that as I am cloning this, it is preserving the curvature between those two loops. So now I can keep adding more of these. I'll end up looking pretty round the more loops that I add in because I have preserved curvature on, versus if I were to turn that off and select this loop over here and use MO again to slide this, and we'll turn off preserved curvature and we'll keep the clone on so that we can just click and drag. can see now I'm moving this loop that we've cloned back and forth, and it is not respecting the curvature of this. And that's basically how that works. And those are all the settings for the slide tool or edge slide tool. And it's been a lot of fun showing you how it works. If you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools and be notified when the next tutorial comes out, please hit like and subscribe so that you'll be notified. And I hope to see you again next week when we go over another 3D modeling tool. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon.